Hello everybody and Happy New Year! Happy 2024! In this video today, I wanted to talk about my 2024 creative projects, so including sewing and knitting, and then also the events that I would like to create things for. If you are new here, my name is Sarah and I am a dual citizen of both the United States and France. I grew up in the United States on the East Coast and then I came to France as a young adult and I never left. I now live and work here, and this channel is all about my sewing projects, a little bit of knitting, and a little bit of my personal life because it does inspire my creative projects. So welcome to this space. So far for 2024, I have nothing planned after June, so I only really know what I'm doing, and this is kind of generally from January to June. I'm very excited because my husband and I are going to be traveling for our honeymoon in May. We are going to be going to Japan, to the Isle of Kyushu, which is the southernmost island in the sort of chain, the main chain of islands of Japan, and I'm really excited. This will be our second time vacationing in Japan, and the first time we went for 2 weeks with my sister and my husband, and we spent 2 weeks doing a more traditional sort of touristy route, as in we saw Tokyo, Kanazawa, Takayama, Kyoto, Nara, Osaka, Himeji, and also Hakone. And it was amazing. It was the best trip I've ever done in my life. And so both my husband and I agreed that the best honeymoon we could possibly imagine would be going back to Japan. So I'm really, really excited. We have our two-way tickets from Paris to Fukuoka, and we need to figure out what we're going to be doing for those 2 weeks. And I'm really excited. And so I was thinking in terms of my wardrobe. I'm already planning what I'm going to be taking with me, and I think May in Kyushu is going to be pretty, not warm, maybe rainy, and so I need to really think about what I want to bring. And I think that my wardrobe is big enough that I won't really need to make too many new garments for it, and I can probably pack all handmade garments with me. But there is one that I'm thinking of making, and it is a one-piece bathing suit. And so I have a few two-piece bathing suits that I've made in the past, all Closet Core Patterns Sophie swimsuits, and I love that pattern, but I don't have any one-pieces. And I think it's going to be not only for the weather, because I think it's not going to be very, very warm when we go, but also I know in Japan people dress a little bit more conservatively. I definitely wouldn't look sideways at someone who has a two-piece on, but I want to fit in a little bit more and I don't want to stand out as much, and I think I'd be more comfortable in a one-piece if we do decide to go to a beach and it's warm enough to go in the water, or if we're in a public place in bathing suits. And so I'm thinking of making a one-piece, and I don't have a pattern in mind yet, so if you have any ideas, let me know. But what I want is something that has like a very low back to show off my back, since I will need straps. Not too thick of straps, and also my bust isn't very big, so I don't need a whole lot of support, but I also don't want a whole lot of cleavage, so I'm thinking something like that, and then a good amount of bum coverage, because I really don't like showing off my bum. It's just something that I feel a little bit self-conscious about, and so something with a good amount of bum coverage, which the Sophie swimsuit definitely has. I might make the Sophie swimsuit again just because I have the fit down, and that would be pretty easy, and I like the way it looks on me, but maybe with detachable straps, I'm not sure, because it doesn't have a very low back, so I will be thinking about that, and also thinking about the color. I'm not sure yet. Maybe a solid color like a periwinkle blue or something would be really nice, but we'll see. And then before our honeymoon, at the end of March, we have been invited to a friend's wedding. So we know a couple who are getting married in the north of France, and they've invited us to their wedding, and I think I'd like to make something fabulous for that wedding. It's going to be more of a cooler weather sort of event, because end of March is still pretty cold in the north of France, but I think that spring will be sort of showing some signs. I think that the foliage will be great, bright green and really beautiful, and we might have a really nice day, so we'll see. Maybe something that's longer. I did see a really beautiful ball gown, and I think what I love about this dress is the colors and the way it drapes. I don't really like the high-low hem. I would definitely make something a little bit more of a straight T-length, mid-calf length, and I think that the bodice is a little bit too tight and small. I think I'd do something different with the bodice, but I love that fabric, so I will be on the lookout for something similar like that, because it's just gorgeous. And then in June, when we get back from our honeymoon, we are going to be going to the ballet. So my colleagues offered us very kindly a gift card for our wedding as a wedding present to go to the ballet. And so we were able to reserve really nice seats at the Paris Garnier, so the Garnier Theater here in Paris, to go see Giselle. and I'm so excited. I do love watching ballet, especially classical ballets, but also contemporary ballets. And so I go to the ballet often, but I usually go in the cheaper seats. So really far away, more affordable. I can see the whole stage, but I can't see their expressions. I won't be front and center, but I will be in the center and down on the first floor of the theater. And so I will definitely probably be able to see their expressions and the details of their costumes. So I'm so excited, and I love the Ballet Giselle. It's one of my favorites, and I just find it so beautiful, so I'm excited. And if you've ever seen the Ballet Giselle, you know that they wear romantic tutus, so the really long sort of floaty ones that go mid-calves. And my wedding dress was definitely inspired by those kinds of tutus, so I just love this ballet, I'm really excited. And I want to make something for it. So I have this silk twill that I bought a long, long time ago from Emma One Sock on the East Coast of the United States. And it's this really, really light, can you hear it? It sings. It's got this really lovely twill. It's very tightly woven, and it's an Italian sort of vintage print of these little flowers. And I would really love to make something. I think it is very floaty. And I was thinking of making something a little bit more structured. So maybe I'll have to underline it and line it with fabrics that will give it a little bit more structure, because I can't, unless I make just a skirt out of it, I'm not sure how to take advantage of this drape, and I don't want to make something like a robe that I wear around the house. I want it to be something fabulous. So maybe it'll be a skirt, and I'll pair it with something simple on top or something really beautiful on top, but I really want to make this for the ballet for June and finally use this fabric, so I'm excited. And then for other more specific sewing projects that I would like to do, there is the Grace Coat that Bella Loves Patterns just published, and I love Bella Loves Patterns, especially her coat patterns. I made the Traveler Coat about a year and a half ago, and it is my favorite tailored make that I've made so far. It is just beautiful, and she includes such gorgeous finishing techniques and haute couture, like very professional, very beautiful techniques for finishing and for constructing, and the pattern pieces come together in a really clever way. And so I am so excited about this coat. It just came out and I already really want to make it. I don't have wool for it yet, and I'm still thinking about the different colors that I might want to make. I'm kind of debating between a light blue or a light beige or a dark forest green, and I'm kind of leaning more towards the dark forest green, but I'm not sure, and I have no fabric in mind. I haven't really started shopping for it yet. I think that'll be a project for late 2024, but I am so excited she's published a new coat pattern. I love her patterns, and I'm so excited to work on this one. The second project that I really want to work on is another pattern by Bella Loves Patterns, and this is the Dolce skirt that came out, I think, about a year ago, and it's a mini skirt and a slightly A-line skirt. I really want to try it because since I made over a year ago, I made a mini skirt out of a wool fabric, and it was a silver pencil skirt hack, and I didn't have very many mini skirts in my wardrobe before, but I ended up wearing it a lot this fall, and I really like it because the thing about wool skirts is that usually I make a pencil skirt and it's below the knee, but it does limit my mobility a bit, and that's something that I think about a lot because I do a lot of walking. I live in a European city, and most of what I do is by foot or public transportation, and so walking to and from the metro, walking to the pharmacy or the grocery store, or the bakery. And so I don't wear heels, and I think a lot about my stride. I get really frustrated if I can't do city walking, so a faster pace to get to where I'm going and at my own most comfortable pace. And especially when it's very windy or cold or rainy, I don't want to be limited by heels or by a skirt that's cutting my stride in half. And so maybe you don't think about this as much, but I think about this a lot. And I noticed with the miniskirt that my range of mobility is still quite large, and it's still very chic, and I feel very good in it. And so I wanted to test out another miniskirt pattern. This one's a little bit more A-line than the silver pencil skirt that I hacked is, but I think that it could be flattering, and I know that her patterns are created with such care, that the construction of the pattern and working on this pattern is going to be a pleasure, and that the inside finishings are going to be just divine. And so I really want to make it, and I have three fabrics in mind, so let me know which one you think would be the best. First, I have this really loose tweed fabric. It's an off-white wool tweed that I got. This is the thickness, and it's more like a basket weave, and you can see through it, and it's not stretchy, but it's definitely a very loose weave, so it has a little bit of mechanical stretch to it, just from the loose weave. And so I would definitely need to reinforce this one quite a lot. I was thinking of making a blazer, like a Coco Chanel style blazer out of this. I think I would still have enough to make a blazer and make a mini skirt, because it only requires 70 centimeters of fabric, which is awesome. Yeah, I was thinking of this one because it's just such a cool sort of tweed. And so let me know what you think about this one. But I do think that the relative drape of this fabric would make it a little bit hard. And the loose weave would mean it would stick to a lot of surfaces or get stuck to things in passing. So that's also something to keep in mind. The second fabric is this really beautiful gray chevron weave. And this is a fabric that I got from Closet Core Patterns, or Closet Core Fabrics, quite a long time ago. I think 2 years ago I bought this with the intention of making the Jessica blazer. And I haven't worked on it yet. I think blazers have been on my mind for years. You might notice a common theme with these fabric purchases, but I'm not sure it would suit me and my style and my silhouette. I'm not sure if it would be too boxy, because I do have shoulders. My shoulders are not too large or too small, but I do think that they're a little bit more square than the rest of my torso, and so I'm worried that it's going to create a very boxy, like between my hips and my shoulders, which is about the same size, and my waist, which is my size is smaller, and my rib cage, which is pretty small. I'm thinking it's going to create a very boxy shape, so I'm not sure. But if it hits high hip and I keep it open, maybe if I wear something high-waisted underneath, it would work. But anyway, I do not have plans to make a blazer yet, but this is what I originally intended for this fabric, and I'm also thinking that maybe I could make a mini skirt out of this and still have enough for the blazer. That's also an option. But it's also more of this like really gray. I'm not sure if it would be a little bit too business looking and not casual enough to be able to wear just every day and around. So yeah, that's an option. And then the last fabric is this really gorgeous woven cotton. And I think I'm leaning more towards this fabric, because look at how beautiful it is. It's got, this really beautiful weave, and it's quite stiff. Like, this is one layer, and so I probably wouldn't have to reinforce it very much to make it hold its shape as a miniskirt. It is more of a optical white than an off-white, and so it might be a little bit too formal, or it might get dirty a little bit too easily, but I really want to work with this fabric, and I think it'd be perfect for a miniskirt, so I think that will be it. I think so. Because it's cotton, I can wash it if it gets dirty, right? Oh, yeah. Let me know what you think. I would like to hear what you think in the comments, so let me know. But I love this one. Oh, okay. In 2024, I also want to continue experimenting with pants. So I made the Brooks jeans in 2023, and I don't wear a lot of pants. Another part of this question of mobility is flexibility. I like not being limited in my movements, whether it's, you know, arm movements or leg movements. And I find that wearing tights with a sweater, knit skirt, or dress means that my mobility is not bothered at all, and I'm enveloped by soft, cushy fabrics. And so going to a jean fabric or pants, it's just, it's not as warm. It doesn't hug my skin as well. And, but anyway, I want to experiment, and I think that, now I'd like to experiment with a more summery sort of pant. I've been looking at the Sewhouse 7 Free Range slacks, a lot, and looking at it on different shapes and seeing if it would fit me, because my concern is my hips are much larger than the rest of my body, except for my shoulders, like I just told you. But, I don't like pants that sort of emphasize how much bigger my bum is to the rest of my body. And I'm wondering if, something with a gathered waist and then looser legs wouldn't make my lower half look twice as large as my upper half. So we'll see, but it looks pretty flattering. It looks like it's a pretty straight leg shape in the bottom. It looks pretty flattering on everybody, so I'd like to try it, and it would be nice to have a pair of summer like linen pants. And I think I have a fabric. It's in the attic though, so I can't show you. It's in my summer stash. It is like a light green linen, and I think that it would be really, really beautiful. So I think I might try making that. And the last project that I have been thinking about and talking about for years and that I'd really like to get to in 2024 is making a really nice nightgown and robe set to wear around the house when I want to feel luxurious. And I have the choice between two different fabrics for the nightgown. So what I could make is more of a lighter sort of summery chemise à la reine style dress. So this chemise à la reine is something that Marie Antoinette brought into vogue back in the day. So I wouldn't want to make something that's historically like 18th century chemise. but I do really want to make something that is light with lots of gathers and kind of off the shoulder and got a little bit of lace. And I really like inserts, like lace inserts. And that sort of look, or I would want elastics at the waist to kind of bring the waist in a little bit, but I also want it to be really floaty and just really comfortable to sleep in the summertime. And I have this really light cotton voile that I could use, and I think it would be really, really nice. The second fabric that I have is this off-white silk twill, and I could make a really lovely nightgown on the bias, maybe more for winter time, but bias cut skirts usually do emphasize my tummy and hips, and I don't always feel very attractive in them, or very, I don't know, I don't think it really looks nice on me, but it's for sleeping in, so who cares? It's about the way it feels, and I, ever since I bought this fabric years ago, I've wanted to feel it against my skin. Yeah, oh. It's so lovely. I'd really like to make something in this soon. Maybe I'll make two nightgowns, one on the bias and one more chemise à la reine style, and then I'll have two luxury nightgowns to wear at all occasions. But yeah, I'd really like to work with this, and that's a project I've been thinking about for a while. And then to go with these two nightgowns is this 100% cotton fabric that I bought in Nippori Fabric Town in Tokyo, that I featured in my vlog where I show you where I went shopping in the fabric town of Tokyo. And I'd really like to use this fabric. I love how there's a slight texture to it, and the colors. It's just so beautiful, and I really wanted to make a robe out of this for my wedding, but that ended up not happening. I didn't have enough time, so I'd really like to get to that. I think that I might not have enough fabric. I have two cuts of, I think, 2 meters of this fabric, but they're very narrow. So selvage to selvage, they're much more narrow panels than fabric usually is. So I think I have a lot less fabric than I need for a calf length sort of robe, so I might end up making a shorter robe, but I'm not sure. Or I can get a really lovely blue fabric. But another thing about this year is I really don't want to buy too much fabric. I have such a large stash. I really want to get to sewing the fabrics that I already have rather than letting my imagination get carried away with new fabrics that I see. There's only so much time in the year to create, and I want to start sewing my stash. So that's another thing about this year. I want to limit, not like a hard no for buying fabrics. I won't go on a fabric ban or a fabric buying ban, but I do want to, as much as possible, use fabric from my stash. So that will be a goal this year, and I will hold myself to it and report back at the end of the year to see if I've stuck to it. So those are all my sewing plans for 2024, and I think it's a little bit ambitious already, but we'll see if I get to them all. For knitting, I wanted to keep learning how to create texture, because I recently made the Cornwall cable knit sweater that I finished in November and that I showed you in my fall sewing mix video, and I really love those mock cables and how squishy that made that fabric that I created. I find it fascinating that with knitting I can create my own fabric, and I love textured fabric. It's a little bit of my obsession is looking for textured fabric, especially in the color white, and I found a new pattern that I am just now casting on, and it is the Discon pattern. It's a word in Breton French, and I'm not entirely sure how to pronounce it, but it means chorus or the refrain of a song, and I just finished swatching it here, so if you can see, there's a lot of texture to it. And it's in this really beautiful merino and recycled cotton wool from Durarum Natura, which is a wool company based in the south of France. And this merino wool, I think it's like 90% merino wool and 10% recycled cotton. And the merino comes from Arles in the south of France, where I have friends who live and who I love very, very much. And yeah, I'm gonna make a sweater. I'm gonna make this sweater out of this yarn, and I think it's gonna look really, really cool. But what I love about this sweater is how textured it is. And so if you know of any other really beautiful textured fabrics, I really wanna try knitting lace work as well. And so if you know of anything that's not too high up, like I don't really like when it's against my neck, and not too boxy, because I don't like very, very boxy knits, let me know. I am very curious, and I really, really want to keep experimenting with making texture with my knits. So that's all of the sewing and knitting projects that I want to do. Recently, I have been really interested in trying out embroidery as well, which I don't know. I think that I have reached my limit of creative pursuits that I can do in my free time between YouTube and sewing and baking and reading and knitting. I just don't really have time for another creative pursuit, but I'm really interested. I'd really like to try, for example, learning how to embroider sashiko style. So it's a Japanese traditional style, and it's made for mattressing fabrics together for warmth and then stitching with a running long stitch. And that's a common theme for embroidery that catches my eye. I was also watching a documentary by Louis Prigent. I'll link the video below. It's fascinating. He covers the Dior show that took place in Mexico recently, and there's some really beautiful Otomi embroidery, Mexican traditional embroidery, in some of the Dior clothes featured, and oh, it is just gorgeous. It's more of a very colorful tradition, but the embroidery that was featured on the Dior clothes was a lot more single color or black and white or dark blue on white, and it's just gorgeous. And then I also saw that in Japanese tradition, there is also Kogen embroidery, which isn't as stippled as sashiko, a little bit more like the Mexican embroidery that I saw, in that it's running long stitches and it's different motifs rather than just lines. And oh, I'd really like to try that too, but so many projects, so little time. And that's another theme of 2024. I want to keep working on this channel and keep producing videos for you. I really love the discourse that we have going on here and being able to share my projects and experience. And I love that you guys come back with inspiration or suggestions, or that we have sort of a community exchange going on. And so I do want to keep making videos, and I have lots and lots of plans that I'm thinking of for 2024. If you have any video ideas for this channel, let me know in the comments below. I am all ears. I would love to see what you want to see from me. I think as an overall goal, creative goal this year, keeping in mind sewing and knitting and embroidery, is that I really want to learn colors a little bit more, like get to know color combinations and color theory a little bit better, because something that I'm finding really fascinating in my wardrobe in the last 2 years is that I'm starting to understand which colors look good on me. And if you have any books or resources that you'd like to recommend for color theory or learning different colors and complementary colors, let me know. But I really want to further explore what kind of colors look good in my wardrobe and that I reach for and that I enjoy wearing and looking at, but also that look good on me. And so that's something I will be exploring a little bit more in 2024 as well. And then my second big goal for 2024 is creating more at-home casual staples, because I love creating going out dresses for my birthday, for example, or for the summertime, or for big events like going to a wedding or going to the ballet. But I don't have a whole lot of casual clothes to wear, especially in the colder months at home on the weekend. And so I would like to work on creating a little bit more, not like t-shirts, because I have t-shirts, but sort of t-shirt adjacent sort of clothes. For example, I'm thinking of the Closet Core Patterns sweatpants that I made 2 years ago that I wear all the time at home. I think it'd be, I can't remember the name of it now, but I will put it in the description below and I will pop it up on the screen here. But it is something that I wear all the time at home, and I think it'd be really nice to have it in another color, for example. But that also implies buying more fabric, so we'll see. All in all, that is all of my projects and goals and objectives for 2024, and I'm really excited. I have linked in the description below all of the patterns that I've discussed, just in case you'd like to go check them out yourselves. Let me know what your creative goals are for 2024. I love hearing from you in the comments, and you inspire me, so thank you very much. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you very soon, and I wish you a very happy new year again, and happy 2024. Bye-bye.